with Terror Ties is set to take over a Chicago area hotel for what could be a major recruitment drive. For the second year in a row, His Boot to Rear is slated to hold its second annual conference next month.
Jeffrey M., founder of the organization responsible for equality and liberty, was a protester at last year's get-together of this same group, which we'll refer to as HT. Jeffrey, great to see you this morning.
Thank you. Great to see you.
Jeffrey, tell us what you saw when you went to this same conference at HT, which is known to have some links to Khalid Sheikh Mohammed, for one. What did you see them saying, and what were the people who went to this conference like?
Well, there were a cross-section of people of different races, different ages, but they appeared to be predominantly individuals from the Chicago area, as well as other Americans. One of the things they spoke about last year was that they seek to create a global Islamic supremacist caliphate, and they used that word supremacy specifically in their talk, where they would seek those people who are not Muslims to have to pay a jizya or a tax to them for the right for safety in the world. Well, otherwise they would attack them.
Jeffrey, go ahead.
The other thing of importance that they did that we pointed out to the Marriott this week is they distributed a flyer which called for the death penalty for those who left Islam.
And this group, as Allison mentioned, is linked to Khalid Sheikh Mohammed, is also linked to al-Zarqawi, is banned in several countries. Why then are they allowed to organize and have this meeting here in the United States?
The United States government does not view them as a terrorist organization, despite their linkages. What we have done is we have challenged them from an ideological point of view, and we have pointed out where they have threatened individuals in government, individuals in universities, where they have made threats to people of all kinds around the world.
Jeffrey, what's interesting is it sounds as though this group used to operate more in the shadows. They sometimes reserved conference rooms under a different name. They didn't necessarily tell people their mission statement. But now they're being more honest about it. Why the shift?
Well, last year we saw the major shift that they wanted to be open because they're looking to recruit new members. Last December, they had another event at a government-managed facility at a Chicago suburb, which we also challenged. And they've had events in Canada and all around the world. They're looking to recruit to create more jihadists and more extremists. I would urge Muslims of America and Muslims of the world to assess, do they want organizations that are against democracy and freedom, like Hizbut Tahrir, to speak for them? I believe that Muslims of America, especially, should speak out against this organization.
Jeffrey M. is the founder of Responsible for Equality and Liberty. Thank you for being here, sir. It's an important story.
Thank you.
Thank you.